All right, thought I'd make a quick video about some of these pagers I've been working on. So this was just a small project which stemmed off of a project I did for a small company that is local to where I live, but I was learning about these awesome radio modules that are available on eBay for almost nothing and using the Radiohead library. So this is the SI-4432, and I thought, hey, how hard would it be to make like a pager or something, like a 1990s style pager? So I have two revisions. This is the first, and this is like the base station. So that's why it's got the jumper on it, and a lot of the components aren't populated, as you can see. This is the first generation, I guess you could say, of the pager, where it's got a little 3D printed case and all the electronics inside. And I'll go over the electronics more on that one up there since it's not in a case, even though this one's just taped. But there's just a single button input, USB, and that USB is just used for charging, little speaker, and it goes into a deep sleep, and then it periodically checks up with the base station. So right now the base station isn't on, so there's a lot of failures, success versus failures up there. And this is a little white OLED display. So we've got like messages, success rates, free memory, and then up on the top there's the battery voltage. And it comes with Mario ringtones. So that's whenever a message is received. And this was mainly for work where I work in a lab and do a lot of automated tests, and I usually get text messages on my phone, but I thought this would be a fun alternative. List the last few messages. Mute it if I want. Go into a deep sleep, which essentially powers it off, and I can send commands back to the base station, which the base station isn't on right now, so it's gonna fail, but really fun project, and getting everything to sleep appropriately was quite a bit of a challenge, and get the current real low once it's in its sleep mode. So like right now it's in its sleep mode, and then it periodically powers up to check with the base station, and when it's in the sleep mode it only draws 56 microamps, which that's not bad for that many electronics. And this is the version that I'm gonna more talk about, and this is based on the same module, or different module, but the same company that makes the module. This is based on the SX-1276, which is known as LoRa radio. It's a LoRa radio. It also just does other modulation types like FSK, GFSK, but I'm just using the LoRa because it's got great range. Oh, I'll mention this SI-4432 module there, that little green one. That I was getting at 433 megahertz, I was getting about half a mile of range, fairly line of sight. It was going through a few light buildings, like residential buildings. This radio is just amazing. This is 915 megahertz. I think I'm running it at 910, which is within our American ISM. 30 dB, so 100 milliwatt transmit power. And I was getting 2 miles with this guy, and at 2 miles with these antennas, well, I guess this is like about a 2 dB gain antenna. This is a 5, so that's the base station I was using with this guy. 2 miles of range though, and that's fairly line of sight. It gets really difficult, like I said, to do range testing past a few miles, especially where I live. Same thing. Just have an additional message that gets displayed here. And so, for example, the base station can send. Here I've got it up along with the CAD of it. But the base station, and this would be done with like a program. So the base station can say, like, hello. Hello there. And this module is currently configured to sleep quite a while before periodically checking up with the base station, so it might take a while to get the message delivered. But there it displays it.
Don't know if you can read that. Yeah.
And then, in case we missed it, oops, that's the reset. This thing does have a watchdog timer running on it. That'll reset it if there's any problems. Ooh, there's an issue. But anyway, a little minor issue. We gotta clear out those characters. Fun little project. And then another thing that I did was this guy, another LoRa board, but on top there's a GPS module. And I've just got a little, ooh, I think that's just a JST connector. JST connector that plugs in, powers everything up. GPS antenna. And then what this does is whenever the base or whenever the pager checks up with the base station, this would be the base station, the base station will text back every single time the position of it in lat long. Might add altitude later, but so this little guy is mainly intended for my drone. Anyway, sometimes my wife's family owns a lot of farm fields, and they're all farmers, so I oftentimes fly over their fields and occasionally have an accident where I'll crash in like a bean field or a corn field, and it is just an absolute nightmare to find that thing. And I would like to be able to have a isolated guy on its own battery that I can just get its location here and then type it in my phone and walk to right about right where it's at. And I'm also going to add a speaker onto this guy. I'm going to probably steal the speaker out of this guy and put in here. and that way I can tell this guy to send a message, and then when this guy receives that message, it'll start beeping periodically. But when I crash on the bean field, it's nearly impossible to find it. And if I crash hard enough where the battery pops out, it could take hours to find. So I think my record is I think I spent about an hour and a half once hunting for this guy in a soybean field, but and I actually ended up using my FPV goggles, and I would wave my hand in front of the antenna slowly, and then when I saw the video got cut out just briefly, I know, oh, maybe it's in that direction, like since my hand was blocking that radio. But anyway, yeah, a little update. And then kind of on the side, I've been considering playing with doing this on my drone too. This is a cellular development board, GPS module, and then I can query it. This is the spark electron, I think, or particle electron development board. Anyway, yeah, just a little update. See ya.